Hello, guys, and welcome to GWF Superstars. I'm Chris, the main commentator, Mark Marks, alongside here, Tim Price, and we're going to be getting it started right here with Asian Kincaid going against Jordy.
Yep, here on Superstars to help well call the action. Well, what a match you've got to start off the show.
Yeah, what a great match indeed to start off the show. Here comes the natural Adrian Kincaid coming out first, and really this will be a really great big match for both these guys in their singles career here. Of course, Jordy just starting his singles career here, and if he can get a win over a man like Adrian Kincaid, what an impeccable win that could be for Jordy.
You have to have to agree with that, because there's no denying what Kincaid has accomplished in his career as a singles competitor. So if Jordy can pin a man like Kincaid, well, my goodness, say a lot about his future.
Yeah, but Kincaid also being very cocky here tonight. He didn't want the Elite out here with him. He said he can get this done all by himself here, that he can take out Jordy. And let's see if Adrian Kincaid can really back up his words here.
Oh man, he would call it ego or arrogance. I like to call it a bit of confidence. And I don't think it's overconfidence.
Well, with all that being said, here he comes. Here comes jumping Jordy.
Yep, here comes jumping Jordy, who, well, his first outing is, you know, becoming a singles competitor. He got a big win. So let's see tonight if he can continue on the trend and, well, pick up a huge win over a man like Kincaid.
Yeah, can he get a big win? I mean, you gotta say, like you said, his first match was a big win in his singles career. It was against Jamie Lethal. But going from a man from Jamie Lethal to Adrian Kincaid, that is a very big difference. And he may, like he sure says, he may have skills all day, but does he have enough skills to take out a man like Adrian Kincaid with everything he's done in his storied career? Can he take out Kincaid here tonight?
Yeah, that's a very good question, and it's one we are kind of finding out here tonight. I mean, yeah, defeating Jamie Lethal, but it doesn't seem like a really difficult thing to do. But Kincaid, it's a whole nother ball game.
Yeah, Kincaid is another ball game indeed. I mean, Jamie Lethal, man, that man's got as many wins as the Browns do in the NFL. But with all that being said, we'll see if how that's going to do here tonight. Jordy, a lot of confidence boost from his first singles win. Of course, losing his tag team partner to the likes of, I believe it was NXT, taking Rob Dundee.
Yep, it certainly was. And, well, it is really a change in pace for Jordy now being out of a tag team and getting into singles. And, well, when it comes down to this match, though, I still have to go with Kincaid, you know, being the man that he is and what he's been able to accomplish in his career.
Yeah, both these men really done a lot in their careers here, and Adrian Kincaid, he's really been through it all. He's really been through the land of hardcore, of course, that ECW life. I mean, very interesting, of course, bringing this match to the outside just to start off here. I think Adrian Kincaid is the one that helps the most.
Yeah, it does, but you saw Jordy there hitting a big crucifix on the outside, and that's going to do a lot of damage.
Yeah, now Jordy looking to celebrate to the fans, but you gotta remember, this isn't Jamie Lethal you're going against. This is Adrian Kincaid.
And Kincaid's
taking him right out there.
Yeah, with that big German, I didn't like the way Jordy landed there. That was nasty, but you could see that's just the veteran instincts of Kincaid.
Yeah, Kincaid really showing off his veteran abilities here, and a big power slam there. And really, Kincaid really showing off why he is really the masterful singles competitor here.
Yes, exactly what he's doing, and he's just, well, looks like he's dissecting Jordy at the moment. And you see the little bit of the cockiness coming through there, but it gives Jordy a chance.
Yeah, Jordy, maybe we'll look for another crucifix. No, a big Hurricane Rana there. And now Jordy really going to try to use his high-flying abilities here to keep up with Adrian Kincaid, but Kincaid, we're going to continue right on him here. And really, I think this is one thing that Kincaid's not used to. Someone that really outmatches him in speed, I would say that would be Jordy. Jordy, I would say, definitely one of the big cruiserweights here in GWF.
Yes, certainly, definitely our match is Kincaid in terms of speed, but Kincaid just showing off the technical ability there and the viciousness. Got into the cover.
Yeah, only a one count from that cover here. And well, you really gotta say, many people have been wondering, why doesn't Jordy go to that new show? Of course, High Impact, where all the cruiserweights at. He says he wants to stay with the rest of the boys here. He wants to stay here in Raw, and he wants to prove that he can make it amongst everybody else here.
Well, that's, you know, definitely some, you know, high confidence of himself to, you know, feel he can do that. But I mean, if he can do it, power tip it. Oh, he is caught in the trifecta.
Yeah, he's caught right into it. And now we can get the third one here. Yes, we are. And down goes Jordy. And again, taking a little bit of an awkward landing there from those Germans.
Yeah, and Kincaid maybe sensing that, going straight into a cover.
Yeah, two. No, only a two count here. You got to give it to Jordy, staying alive in this matchup, but may not be much longer. Kincaid calling for the end here, and a big code breaker.
Oh, it's just a nasty code breaker that ends the cover. This is surely it.
No, Jordy staying alive.
Good lord, that. Not many people could kick out of code breaker, but Jordy just showed it. Showing the heart of a warrior here.
Yeah, showing the heart of a warrior, showing that he has what it takes to get in. And now Kincaid telling Jordy to get up, maybe looking for some high flying abilities of his own here. High flying, missing the drop kick. And really, what is leading Adrian Kincaid to do such high risk maneuvers here? Stuff he's really going out of his comfort zone here.
Yeah, he really is. I mean, maybe he thinks he needs to do that to take, you know, get on Jordy's level and beat him. But oh, good lord! And oh, you can see, I think he might be bloodied.
Yeah, what's to be cut open here, Jordy? Getting cut open here, and well, this is not an unfamiliar sight for Adrian Kincaid, blooding open his opponents here. Of course, like I said, back in the land of ECW, he used to do that on the daily. Now he's doing it here on Superstars. Jordy, though, still able to fight back, but might not be too much long until the blood starts getting into his eyes.
Yeah, and that's where you get blinded, and your vision becomes really impaired, and it becomes very difficult.
Yeah, now Jordy looking to get him up here, and oh, and there's the nice suplex there. Now, what does Jordy have in mind here? Not going for those big kicks. Now taking him to the center of the ring.
Oh, and now just working on the arm there. Just trying to really work over Kincaid.
Yeah, now taking him into the corner. Spinning around, what does Jordy have in mind? Jordy maybe going for more of that jumping Jordy style here. He's going up.
Oh, here we go. Oh.
And the big jumping clothesline there. And Kincaid can be out, but that took a lot out of Jordy. Now finally able to go into cover. One, two, only a two count. And I think it's just took Jordy way too long to go for that cover. He's getting too exhausted in this matchup now.
Yeah, I think he definitely is just getting a little bit too exhausted there, and it's really sharp, but these men are just pulling it all out on the stops here on Superstars, just showing how much they want that win.
Yeah, how much they want that win, how much they want to improve their singles career. Jordy again telling Kincaid to get up here. Is Jordy going to be putting him away here? Going for the double axe handle. Kincaid able to sidestep it, and what's it, going for a super kick and a miss, but now maybe locked into the triple suplex here.
Yeah, go for him again. There's the second. Here comes the third.
And there it is. And Jordy may just be out of it. Kincaid, oh, now really showing off. Kincaid's showing off that big confidence he has right now. But no, wait. Jordy,
oh, but look
at
that.
Hurricane Rana may have some fighting spirit left in him here. Maybe going for the cover. Can he put him away here? One. Two, no, only a two count.
Yeah, that's just not good enough there. And this match still can't all. What a match it has been. These two just pulling out all the stops.
Yeah, Jordy and Kincaid doing whatever they can to pick up the win here. But now, big arm drag there. No, no, wait. Kincaid fighting back here. Now send him in the middle of the ring. What does he have in store? Wait. Going for his own. Oh, my goodness. It's like double hook backbreaker there. And this could be it.
Yeah,
it's just there. No.
No.
Two count.
Really, what is it going to take to either of these men to put the other away? As we're seeing now, Kincaid looking like he's trying to work over the cup maybe a bit more.
Yeah, I think I've definitely been seeing a lot of new moves out of Asian Kincaid's moveset here. I mean, he's really doing everything he can to try and take out Jordy. Jordy starting to feel it now. Maybe the fans getting behind him here. No, Asian Kincaid fighting back. And now a third time. Into the three suplex here, into that trifecta.
Oh, this surely this time he has to be over. It hits the third, and
yeah, now,
he's dragging him away. Go for the cover, ring. I believe.
This has to be it. One, two, three, and a big win for Adrian Kincaid. Really, a well fought win, and nothing to be brought down there to Jordy.
No, I definitely have to agree that, you know, big up to Jordy, that he really showed that, you know, he can get it done. Give it the time, give it a bit more training in the singles competition. I think Jordy could become a big star on Raw.
Could become a big star on Raw indeed. But for now, Adrian Kincaid, really a very warm welcome into the singles competition here. But now, we got coming up next to Yuri Watson, will be going against the Dancing Chocolate Man, Yango.
Yep, he'll be, well, the savior. Kenswell, the Dancing Chocolate Man.
Yeah, well, coming out first, he is the intellectual savior of the masses, Yuri Watson.
And he truly is like intellectual savior, the man people should aspire to be like. Just look at him.
Yeah, just look at him come down in that very excellent robe down there. And you really can't tell. He is that intellectual savior that we need. When you see him inside the ring, the way he wrestles is just absolutely brilliant. It's smart. I mean, he can see anything coming from a mile away.
And that is why he is, you know, one of the best in-ring technicians, is because of his smarts. And I think we're going to see it here tonight, the smarts he has.
Yeah, and I mean, I was able to get a talk of Yuri Watson. He says he sees every match as if it was like a chess match. While others are thinking about the next move, he's thinking 10 steps ahead of him. He's thinking 10 moves ahead on his way to victory.
And that, exactly that is why Yuri Watson is one of the best. And again, just a big star.
Yeah, we'll see if he can prove it here tonight against the Dancing Chocolate Man, Yango. Of course, one of our newly drafted men coming over had a chance to go for the United States gold, didn't get it there. Willie Street, of course, our new United States champion. And we will see him in action tomorrow night. But with all that being said, all we're waiting on now is the Dancing Chocolate Man. And here he is. Here comes Yango, a former GWF NXT champion.
Yes, yes, he is. And here is the Dancing Chocolate Man himself. I mean, I could never really truly take him seriously. He's not an intellectual savior like the great Yuri Watson.
Yeah, well, what he doesn't have in intellect, he makes up in his dancing moves, and just look at him go.
Yeah, he knows how to get the audience behind him, but
yeah, he is absolutely a fan favorite here on Superstars. The fans love them, the Dancing Chocolate Man Yango. He is definitely the crowd pleaser, the crowd favorite here. But let's see if he can pull up a big win over the intellectual savior Yuri Watson. I think I already know your answer.
Well, yeah, I'm going with the intellectual savior, that is Yuri Watson.
Yeah, let's see if Yuri Watson can live up to what he says here. He says that while people like Yango may only think about their next move, he says he thinks 10 moves in advance. Let's see if he's going to prove that here tonight. Let's see if he can use that to his victory here.
You're going to have to see, but there he is, just a thinking 10 steps ahead. Your rewards are just so smart, and it's just so vicious there.
Yeah, now just Yuri Watson just attacking the back of Yango now, and really just strategically going after that back, maybe thinking about going something down the line, of course, going for that back, but oh, and great agility of Yango. Now, you may not think of him as a big man to have such great agility, but just look at that big jump, just really squishing down Yuri Watson, but Yuri able to be fighting back now.
Yeah, I mean, you can't deny the athleticism there to pull off the mushroom stomp like that with ease to be such a big pair. But again, Yuri Watson just has the in-ring smarts to keep so far ahead of you.
Yeah, now look at this, but now the strength of Yuri Watson. Now, he doesn't look like a professional bodybuilder, but this man has the strength to pick up a man like Yango with ease.
Yeah, he does. I mean, we're saying about Yango and his athleticism, but then you have to talk about Yuri Watson and some of the strength he sometimes shows possesses. Already got into cover, just, I think, just, you know, trying to rub it into Yango saying, I've got you.
Yeah, saying, I got you. I can lift you up like nothing. Really, I think that's something that's definitely going to be bringing Yango into surprise there. That surprising strength of Yuri Watson is now he's continuing on with the knees onto Yango.
Yeah, Yuri Watson's just dominating as well. Pig Spinebuster, double A style.
Yeah, now going for the cover yet again. One, two, no, only a two count. Yuri, so far, he's really showed off his smarts here, really dominating this matchup so far. And can he already be going for the ends here?
Yuri might be as... Oh, pedigree!
Yeah, going for a big pedigree. Yango looks absolutely motionless.
Yuri does. I mean, I'm surprised he did go for what we know as Yuri special, but
he's
changing it up.
And Yango is still out. I haven't seen him move.
No, I haven't. I mean, I think that just shocked. Yeah, I don't think Yango saw that coming. I think he might have thought the Yuri special was coming. And no, the pedigree gets hit. And that is why Yuri Watson is just such a smart and intellectual man.
Yeah, well, like he says, he likes to be 10 moves ahead. I feel like there was only 10 moves used in this match. He is just absolute brilliance of Yuri Watson.
And you can see Yango still not moving. Up now he's finally
able to move. I mean, he's just barely able to roll outside the ring. I think he's getting some medical attention now. But now we got ourselves our main event of the evening. Here is a triple threat ladder match, as it seems to be the Royal Family against Morgan Wolf here.
Yeah, I mean, this is very interesting. It's put a triple threat, but could this turn into a handicap match?
Yeah, can it turn into a handicap match indeed? And well, since it is a triple threat, they will not be coming out as a tag team. Coming out first, it is Draco Child.
Well, here comes Draco Child, and what an opportunity this could be for him. I mean, but the fact is, he is going in there against his brother Mason Child, and we do have, well, the self-proclaimed king of ladder matches, Morgan Wolf, in there.
And well, I do have a message about this match coming from the Superstars general manager, Jen Michaels. I will be telling that at the beginning of this match, but there's definitely a very special stipulation of this match going into this, and very interesting to see which one of these men are going to want this prize, well, a little bit more, but well, I'll talk more about that as the match starts. But Draco Child looking ready here, and of course, the Royal Family had a giant upset victory last week on Superstars against the Elite.
Yeah, I don't think anyone saw that victory coming, but now the Royal Family showing they can't get it done as a tag team.
Yeah, but can they get it done in singles where they may have to really go against each other here?
Yeah, exactly, as well. Here comes Mason Child making his way down to the ring.
Yeah, Mason Childs making his way down to the ring. The children have been brought back together. Mason Childs making his debut into GWF last week. But really, the history between Mason and Draco really goes far back into the early times of NSW, of course, back in those days. And really, a really great rekindleship here of, well, these brothers.
There it is. I mean, I don't think many people expected Mason Childs to be back, well, in the wrestling ring, specifically in GWF. I think a lot of people thought it was done, but here he is now in GWF along with Draco and Childs. But tonight they've got to fight each other.
Yeah, they got to fight each other. And of course, throwing that into the mix is this former longest reigning GWF United States champion, Morgan Wolf.
Yep, here he is. Yeah, the former United, well, yep, former United States champion, of course, Cesaro being the former, but who beat Morgan Wolf to, you know, take that title. Now, Morgan Wolf, well, I don't know if you've seen the mood he's been in since losing his U.S. title. Stop in a happy mood.
Not been a happy mood. And he seems to have been absolutely desperate to try to get that title back, but he lost that number one contendership match to Cesaro. And so as of right now, that match, Cesaro and Willie Street, a clash of champions, of course, on January 8th, will be making its way. Morgan Wolf, I'm sure he's going to do everything he can to really take that United States Championship back.
Yeah, I'm sure he definitely wants to do that, but last time Morgan Wolf was in singles action, he did lose to Cesaro, so it's going to be, I think, difficult for him maybe to get back into, you know, contention for the U.S. title.
Well, it's funny as you say this, though. Talking about that news coming from the Superstars general manager, Jen Michaels, he is saying that he can make number one contendership matches as well, and he is adding in to this match, they will get into the United States title match at Clash of Champions, effectively making it a triple threat at Clash of Champions. And the winner, of course, will be going into the United States title match.
Wow, this is very interesting. This definitely brings on to, you know, more motivation for Morgan Wolf to get, you know, into that matchup as well. Look at this.
Yeah, nice chance. Draco Child
fight each other. Oh, Morgan Wolf wanted to take advantage, but doesn't. And the king of self-proclaimed king of ladder matches. Is he going to show exactly why he's got that nickname?
Yeah, even though he wasn't able to regain his championship in the six-man ladder match at the first episode of Raw, but can he do it here tonight? Can he pick up the win now knowing that he can be going for the United States Championship at Clash of Champions, taking on both of the royal family and really only bring out these knockout punches?
Oh, just bringing them out so quickly. Draco Childs getting back up and he needs to rush back in that ring. He does exactly that.
Yeah, he needed to rush back inside, realizing what was happening. Mason is up. Can this be Mason's chance? Is Draco going to allow this to happen? Morgan now up there with him. But, oh, and down they go. And now Draco continuing on there. It's Morgan outside the ring.
Yeah, Morgan's not in the right place to be in this sort of matchup on the outside. I mean, gives him a chance to rest, but also could sacrifice six matches. A GTS by Draco Child.
Yeah, big GTS. And out goes Mason. And is that going to continue? Is that going to allow Draco to pick up number one contendership going into a triple threat? No, a big punch from Morgan making Draco lose control. And now Mason taking out the ladder.
Yeah, both those two just go flying down. And this is Mason Child's chance. Oh, but Morgan's catch straight back up.
Yeah, Morgan now realizing Mason is climbing there. Taking him out, make sure he has no chance here. Draco trying to take down both men by himself. Yes, he does.
Yeah, but both teams made her out of it. And all Mason Charles Rollins here outside. And
yeah, but can we Jericho be seeing Charles the last
raid? Telling Morgan to get up.
Last raid!
Hits it!
Draco, this could be his chance to get into the United States title match. Make himself famous.
Yeah, all he's got to do is set up the ladder. I mean, he had difficulty doing that, but that was his chance. Mason Charles is still a bit woozy.
Yeah, Morgan still Morgan's trying to get out Mason. Just now getting in, now stopping Draco. Morgan now starting to climb and trying to take him out. Now we've maybe seen Mason trying to take out the ladder here soon. But no, hasn't gone for it yet. Draco up top, and now Mason takes out the ladder.
Yeah, look at this. Morgan's again rolled to the outside, and Draco Charles completely out of it. This is Mason's chance.
Yeah, Mason's best chance right here. Can he pick up the gold? Well, not gold, even the number contention to get into the gold match.
Oh, Draco's going to stop him now as he's fighting him off of that briefcase with the very poor contract to get into, well, the match to make it a triple threat.
Yeah, get into Clash Champion, and both the Royal Family are down. Morgan is up. All he needs to do is climb. Get into that United States title match. He is up.
Yep, he's up there. Draco's having difficulty getting up.
Mason's
can he stop Morgan?
Outside.
I don't know if he can.
He's climbing. He's getting it. He's getting it. Does he have it? Not yet, but Draco biding his time. He needs to get up there faster. Yep. There he goes.
Maybe he was thinking, you know, Morgan's loosened it up a bit more. It's a very tight grip. That's good. But look at this. Mason Child in.
Yeah, Mason Child is in. Both men look to be almost thrown to the outside. Morgan barely still inside the ring. He's hanging onto the ropes to stay in. Realizing Mason is climbing. This can be it.
Yeah, this could be his moment. But Morgan Wolf's taking too much time. But now he's able to stop Mason Child.
Yeah, now Morgan Wolf bite!
Oh, Jesus!
And that, I think, is Mason Child out of his matchup. Now climbing with Draco, taking out the ladder.
Yeah, taking out the ladder. And, look at this. Morgan
Draco's
to the outside.
Chance.
Yeah, it is his chance as Mason looks
but
complete.
What is he doing?
What the hell is Draco doing here?
He just can't seem to figure it out.
Yeah. I don't know if you could see this, but it looks almost like the ladder's caught on his tights, maybe.
Yeah, it may have been caught on his tights there. He realized he needed to get rid of that ladder fast, and really, that may have cost him a number one contendership opportunity to get into Clash of Champions.
Yeah, I think it did. And what the hell is Draco doing
Draco
here?
Draco, again, a little bit woozy there. You know what? I think we might need to check on Draco to see if he's okay. I don't think he's in the right state of mind. But Morgan,
because look at this,
taking
Morgan
full
Wolf
advantage, using that ladder. Draco
up.
Finally letting go of that ladder,
realizing what the hell he was doing.
But now he's just watching as Morgan Wolf gets the United States Championship opportunity. He is going to Clash of Champions.
Well, Morgan Wolf yet again, well, showing that he really knows how to get it done in ladder matches. I mean, I don't know what happened to Draco there. He had the match won.
Yeah, he had the match won there indeed, but Draco, something happened to him there. He must have got caught on his sights. Anything could have happened there. But with all of that being said, that is the it of Superstars. And well, Tim, say goodbye to the fans.
Goodbye, fans.
And I'm, of course, the main commentator, Mark Martz, and I will see you guys tomorrow night for Raw.